listening to Jan Talk.
Go.
We in the jungle, baby.
Number one.
Welcome to the Jan Talk podcast. It's your boy, Mike J. I got Groovy Drew, Trev, Keisha, and Shell. And today we're talking about friendships and relationships. Can you build a friendship into a relationship? And can you be friends after a breakup? And we just want to go around the table and get people's opinions. Who's going first? Buckwheat?
Look at that, man. Man,
did I upset you, Buckwheat?
Crap.
Oh, you want me to go first?
Yeah.
If it's not genuine, it's not going to work. Because shit, you have a whole agenda trying to build a friendship. So you really pretty much playing your part and hoping that, she like the female or the male picks me. So shit, like you really not there for the friendship. You really there for your own personal gain. So in layman terms, y'all, if it does work, if you do break up, that shit gonna be a disaster because she ain't nobody that know how to act around the person no more. So like, They always be in their feelings and stuff. So, I would say avoid it.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else?
I would say do what you feel is right. If you feel it, do it. If you don't feel it, don't do it.
I say don't
either. I'm with Drew.
Because, yeah. That's why I said don't stay within the group or the clique, because you might approach them about dating. They may not feel the same way. They don't get shot down. There's gonna be that little tension and jealousy when they bring the other significant other.
Yeah, yeah.
I wish you could
pretty much vice versa. Awkward.
Out as friends. Oh, thank you, man. Mm-hmm.
I've been there.
That's a couple that started out as friends.
But it wasn't genuine, though. Where it's like genuine.
No. I'm saying like they started up like legitimate friends.
Even if they were like childhood friends, you know?
No.
I love to meet a couple that, you know, they started out as genuine friends and then it blossomed into something else. And now they've been married for forever.
Now, in that case, it might work. But like somebody like, say, fancy Keisha, you meet this person like, shit, I want to meet this dude. Like, damn, I just want to be a friend and stuff. But he tells you like, hey, I know you can barely tell like he really does like you and want a relationship from you, but he acting as like he's your friend trying to friend his way to you, friend his way into a relationship. Which so how would you feel about that?
I mean, if I've already made it very clear where I stand, I mean, you're pretty much setting yourself up. So if I say, hey, I only want a friendship and nothing more, and you're still doing the most to try to get me to change my mind, then sorry for you.
Oh, I got a perfect example, Trav. I don't want to say her name.
Yeah, you don't have to. You don't say her name?
Let me see if y'all know what I'm talking about. It was like when old girl Kel, I told Mike about it. She was always consistently asking when we gonna hook up, but I always turned it down because the timing was bad because I was going through that phase.
Yeah, like, the whole phase.
Yeah, basically. And like, I just want to have fun and do me. And I want to put her through all that because I know she's a good person. So I just try to save all the hassle and all the drama that's going to happen in the future with. But I was going to bring what my situation had going on then. So I just didn't want that to happen to her and put her through all that. So that's why I just shot it down all the time.
Yeah.
So what if the whole phase ended and you decided to go ahead and try things out with her, but then, you know, it ended up not working. Do you still see yourself as being friends with her after the fact?
With me and her, we knew each other since like what, eighth grade, and she used to talk to my cousin. But it was like one of them relationships that they had, like it was like, you know, over the phone back in middle mm-hmm. school, high school, over the phone shit. But she never took it that serious, and I told her about that. I said I can't see you like that because you used to talk to my cousin. She said it wasn't even that serious because we never met up and it was always over the phone. But with me, I don't care if it's not serious or if it was serious. I'm not going after my cousin's girlfriend or whatever. I just can't do that. That's why I kept sitting down also as well. And I just stayed friends with her.
Mm. Yeah, and that's totally different.
Yeah, but in her eyes, it was like, fuck your cousin. I want you now, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, but still.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how I grew up. I ain't going after my friends, exes, or family exes or none of it.
That's the code. I mean, if you you just can't you just can't go in there with no like hitting the attentions and shit. You gotta let it be known right there, because if you get put in the friend zone, you get in your feelings, you know. Hey, just leave it alone. I don't know. Some men's ego is so fragile. Like, if a girl turned them down, they just be in a bad bitch mood or some shit. Like, all these women out here, why don't you just go find you another one? You wasted your time on somebody who says it's not going to work. Go find you another one.
But I feel like y'all looking at it just that one-sided. But look at it as in starting off as friends, genuine friends, and end up trying it as a relationship. Both of you agree to the relationship.
Mm-hmm.
It did not work.
Mm-hmm.
We're being able to be friends with that person how you started off as. Not saying one or the other don't like each other as much. Y'all both agreed to try things out and be in a relationship. Maybe even fall in love.
I would still say no.
Nope.
Because with me, knowing how I am, like, say I tried it with Sally and it didn't work out and we agreed to be let it go. With me, I think a lot. And I see her having fun and shit. I'm like, damn, I should have tried harder and shit. Maybe I should try again, blah, blah, blah. And I don't like to go back once we made a decision afterward. Cause I'm a deep thinker. I think about shit like that. So that's why, even with that, I just leave it alone. If I should have done it, I should have done it from the first time. I don't have to second guess shit.
True.
Yeah, so a lot of people say, you know, it's best to date, you know, your best friend. But, you know, I just, like I said, I really wouldn't want to jeopardize. Like, even, you know, me being with somebody that I've been friends with for, you know, say 10 plus years. And we did try, okay, us hanging out now. And say, for instance, if I bring somebody around, it's totally different than, you know, us getting together, falling in love, then after the fact we break up, then me bringing somebody around after the fact. Like, that's two different scenarios. So I don't see stuff like that happen. But a lot of people, they swear that's who you should date, your best friend. But I don't see it that way.
Me either. That's Hollywood shit. Like, when people say that, they mean you meet somebody. Sometimes you meet your best friend in a relationship. Like, when you get in a relationship with somebody, especially a serious relationship, it's supposed to grow as best friend. Mm-hmm. Like, you and that person supposed to be able to talk about everything, have a discussion about everything. It should be no gray areas. Y'all should be able she need to be able to talk to you like she wanted, like, you one of her homegirls and everything. Dang shit. Like, she just need to be able to tell you, like, with one of her homegirl tripping or some shit, like, she just need to talk. Everybody, like, that's the most important part in a relationship, communication. That's what they really mean by, like, what is, like, that's like our people. You should marry your best friend, because once you're in that committed relationship, that person becomes your best friend. Because that's the person you talk to every day. That's the person you damn near almost do everything with. So that person pretty much becomes your best friend.
But I mean, I get what you're saying, but it's people that say you should get with the person that you've been friends with, because y'all been friends, y'all know each other, y'all comfortable with each other. A lot of people say that as well. Not necessarily, okay, I meet somebody, you know, we become best friends. But a lot of people say that, you know, oh, you should date your best friend because y'all comfortable with each other and y'all know each other. And then once y'all break up, then y'all understand, you know, the friendship boundary and all that. But a lot of people think like that, though.
Well, I know, but
think like that too. Though, but I think like that to an aspect. My thing is this: if I was to hook up with a best friend, it wouldn't be off the strength of influence from other people at all. It would be because, okay, I actually, on my own terms and on their own terms, they said, you know what, this we might have something a little more special than a friendship going on here. You know, that's my whole thing about it. Like, if it naturally happens, then cool. But I'm not, I mean, I kid you not, when I was in college, I was roommates with two guys. We had a three bedroom. I was the only female in the house, but I was roommates with two guys. One of the guys was dating my best friend, and the other guy, he was single. He was single. And, you know, everybody used to make jokes that me and him should be together. Me and him should be together. Me and him should be together. But him and I knew we ain't looked at each other like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, we were cool. We were able to cook together. I saw his, you know, good, bad, and ugly. But we knew that we didn't have anything past the friendship, you know? So, I mean, it's all in a matter of the two people that's involved, because I mean, like I said, you know, and everybody used to sit up there. They used to sit up there and make jokes. They used, you know, like, yeah. Y'all practically married. Y'all live together, this, that, and the third.
Used to hate that shit.
Yeah. And it's like, you know, like that's my boy, you know, like that my homie, like for real. He used to bring home girls and you know, I ain't care, like for real. Like this is your home too. I didn't care.
But you know, like you said earlier, Keisha, like it is a maturity thing. Because some people can do it. Some people can do it with no problem. So it is sometimes it does fall back on your maturity level.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I ain't gonna lie, like in the recent years, I thought about it. Maybe I should have. But then I was like, maybe not.
You know what I just said?
Because it's like, you know, I know me. You know, he saw sides of me that only my friends would actually see. Yeah. It. Like, hell no. We get in an argument. You bring that shit up. Hell no. Man.
Oh, yeah. See, that's scary part of that shit.
Yeah.
Like, bring damn, they break on stains and shit. We don't, like, my friends only see, like, you don't want that shit, like, if something do happen, y'all get in an argument, they throw that shit back up in your face and shit. Yeah. Like, yeah.
So you know they will.
Yeah,
I mean, the friends, you know, thing is, it's a sensitive subject, but it's a matter of understanding on both parties. Like, even if you find yourself falling for your friend, if your friend makes it very clear, hey, I don't pass that, then you need to just leave it as that. Quit trying to prove yourself to this person. Because if they don't see you like that off the strength of the friendship alone, then that should be all the confirmation that you need.
Yep.
Do y'all think that, you know, starting off as just legitimate friends, it's better, you know, like relationship wise, is, you know, you have a stronger relationship starting off as just genuine friends.
Yeah. I don't see if you genuine friends. Now, it's kind of like one of those, like, we genuine friends. So if we genuine friends, it should not go to that point.
But like Keisha just said, she knows somebody that been friends since childhood and they still married.
Hey, yeah.
That's them.
Different, well, social, I mean, different
I know,
folks.
I know, yeah, I know it's his opinion. But
first, a friendship being built before I actually. But I mean, that's what I would prefer, but that's not real life. Hell, majority of the people I dated, I was never friends with them in the beginning. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And that's just being 1,000 with it. I would prefer an actual friendship prior to evolving into something more, but I mean, that's what a preference. But I mean, honestly speaking, I never, other than the one situation I was in, I've never actually dated a friend. But then again, looking back on that, I honestly speaking, the situation was more so we both, and I'm not even going to just sit up there and try to put it on him. We were good friends off the strength of the fact that we both knew there was something there. But because of that person's situation, we never went there. So when they got out of their situation, And, you know, I was still around. Of course, we tried to explore a relationship. But that's why I said you got to be mindful, because when there is a hidden agenda, you're only showing you're good. And so when there was a hidden agenda, all I saw was the good. All I saw was how great this person was. And when he went through what he was going through, how could somebody do my boy like this? He's an amazing person. And then when we started dating, I kid you not, I had to tell him, I said, I don't blame her one bit for doing you the way she did. Because, you know, when you get in that relationship, you start seeing other sides to a person. You're like, where the fuck this nigga been this whole time?
But, you know, that's the same with, you know, anybody. Me,
that just goes to show me that the friendship wasn't really a genuine friendship. It was more so us trying to advertise our best selves for that other person. And, you know, I'll take accountability on that end, because the situation was so weird, because he actually started as a client, somebody whose hair I was doing. And I had a notion that he had a girlfriend, but he never actually came out and said he had a girlfriend. It just so happened during one of our sessions where I was doing his hair, and the girlfriend called and was like, hey, da da da. But when the conversation between him and his girlfriend was over, there was this awkward silence between us, because it was like, okay. So then when I saw that he had a girlfriend, of course, I'm gonna respect the relationship. And I played my part accordingly. And I was like, okay, well, we obviously can't be nothing more than, you know, this situation. And when it ended, he leaned towards me more, and I was there for him. And we tried, and we failed miserably. It was, like I said, it started out as, how could she do you like that? To, I don't blame her one bit. I would have did your ass. Goddamn way. Because you start seeing this side of a person, the side that they never really showed you. And with your friends, you know the good and the bad and the ugly with them. And so he was only showing me the good. He was only showing me his good side, but he was only promoting himself. And it wasn't that he was promoting himself to actually be with me, but he was attracted to me. And he was attracted to me, but he was still a good guy. He wouldn't put himself in a predicament where he would actually cheat on his girlfriend. But he always, you know, it was always positive energy whenever we was around each other, this, that, and the third. But like I said, when him and her broke up, me and him explored a relationship, and it was just horrible. I mean, it was like, oh, wow. Yeah, I didn't know you had the side to you like that. Now I'm understanding.
And that's why I go against, you know, dating your friend, because I don't want to see that side of you. I want to see your friendship side.
But the thing is, with a friendship, it comes with the good and the bad. Friends are able to sit there and yell at
me. I'm talking about relationship-wise.
My best friend for the longest, me and her have been able to yell and scream at it. We've actually physically fought. And we have been friends since we were 6 years old. But, you know, you see all this side to a person, but that doesn't change the way you look at that person. Because me and her can fight on Wednesday. But if somebody talked about her on Thursday, I'm coming for their ass. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's that family type bond. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can say whatever I want to say about my best friend, but if you say the exact same thing, I'm coming for your head. It's those type of bonds that, you know, you really have to decipher if that's what you guys really have. I didn't explore that with this particular individual. It was only the good I was basing it off of. And it was like, you know, he was always like, you're always bringing positive energy to my life, and blah, blah, blah. Of course I'm only bringing positive energy here, like, because I'm only bringing the good. But then when we actually got together and shit started hitting the fan, you know, it was like, And then the aspects that actually made me a good friend to others wasn't really working for him, because it was like, I'm brutally honest. And so here we are, we're dating. Here we are 6 months later, you and her still arguing about the same bullshit y'all was arguing 6 months. And we sitting there like,
what the hell was that?
Tommy's like, y'all ain't talking.
What was it?
What was up?
Sorry, joking.
Hello.
Yeah. Continue.
So we'll wrap this up.
So you,
but yeah,
somebody
I mean,
breaking up.
Yeah, Keish, yeah, you back in now?
It's hit or miss. Yeah.
No, I wouldn't personally. I wouldn't do it. Like it hit or miss. Then like shit. It's open up. Open up like what old cliche, open up a can of worms. That shit can go, it can eat them. Like, I don't think it go good, because like only time you see that shit working is on TV or some shit. Like in real life, that shit ain't gonna work. It do, but
you know what I said? It's better just eat out of real randomly that you don't even know. You got a better chance with that.
Mm-hmm. Like DMX said, how's it going down?
Yeah. They got to put time in anything.
Let me know.
DMX also said it was Brenda. Keish.
What do you be too old from a nigga?
Hello.
I'm like.
Hello.
You can't be no hitting and gelling, though. You can't, like, you know, a lot of niggas be coming in like, I want to be a friend. No, damn well, they want to fuck with you. Like, you can't be like that. Now, that shit ain't going to work. You gotta be 100 and gotta be genuine. Like, that's why I said you cannot friend your way into no ass if that shit ain't genuine. That shit gotta be genuine. Like, you gotta really want to be this female. I'm gonna speak from a male perspective. You gotta really want to be this female friend. Now, if it grows from that, cool. But if he just come in, I really want you, but I'm act like I'm your friend. Nah, that shit ain't gonna work, and that shit kind of lame. This shit suck. This is some suck shit to me.
It is
suck ass shit.
But you know what? And I know we're gonna wrap up this subject, but it's funny we're bringing. Is I meant to bring it up, you know, earlier, but I'm in a situation now where it's like, and I'm gonna ask y'all opinion about it privately, but it's like, I don't know if you're trying to build a friendship or if you're trying to get to know me better. That there, I'm having a hard time deciphering between the two. I'm not even gonna lie to you, because it's like we be laughing and we be kikiing and this, that, and third. But it's like when we're around each other, it's not like he's all in my face or anything like that. But it's a sense of shyness when he's around me.
Oh,
and I don't know if
I used to be like that.
Yeah, me too.
And nah, I don't know if it's because does he like me or is he trying to build an actual friendship? That is something I'm actually having a hard time determining. Like, are you really trying to be my homie, or are you trying to be somebody that? You know, are you trying to be somebody to, you know, get to know me so it can elevate, blah, blah, blah? I don't know. Mm-hmm. I really don't know, because our encounters is always, it's this awkwardness. But maybe when we're speaking like on a personal level, just texting or whatever, we cool as hell. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, we chum chummy. But then when we're like around each other physically, it's like this sense of awkwardness. It's more so.
You got you a Drew.
What do I feed a Drew? I don't know, like for real. And it's like, and that is where my downfall with dating comes in, because like Drew, I'm an overthinker. So it's like, am I thinking in the right direction? Is this, because I'm one of those people that I want to stay in my lane. I need to know what lane I need to stay in, like, for real.
Well, have you asked them?
Huh?
Have you asked them?
No, because I don't want to create awkwardness.
Some niggas like that aggressive shit.
Huh?
Some niggas like that aggressive shit.
See, that's the thing, though. I'm outspoken, but I'm not aggressive. I'm not a, come here, nigga. I'm not that. Oh, like,
some niggas love that shit. Like, for real.
But I don't care. Here's the thing. If you're a man that loves that, then you're not going to get that up out of me.
Cow.
I don't know, but it's like, you know, it's like, it's a lot of underlying shit. I actually brought this person to y'all attention one time because y'all told me they in a group with y'all or whatever, like some sports group or whatever. And I'm
we told you what to do.
As in, like, when I say recently, I'm talking about today that transpired. And I was like, I'm going to send y'all the screenshot. Y'all be like, y'all let me know what's what, because I don't know. I don't know if he just tried to kick it with a homie or he tried to kick it with me, for real, you know? But then that's going to lead into the next topic, because if we do kick it like that,
oh, Lord.
And then things go to the next level.
Oh, my God. I'm going to bed. Good night, y'all.
No, I'm ready for this one. And like that, we're going to end it off.
Just on the
next segment. Yeah, nah, we just, hey, I'm going to break it up right here, then I'm just put some in the head, and we're going to go to the next segment.
I'm going to send y'all the screenshot. I'm going to send y'all the screenshot, and I just want you to let me know.
Look, like, well, let me see the screenshot first.
All right, wait, let me end the segment. I'll make sure I save this time. Then we're going to come back with the next segment. Ladies and gentlemen, we end this segment, I'll say, it's like, you can be, like, if you want an actual relationship with a person, say that and be genuine about it. Don't do no sucker shit and try to hide your true intention of being the person under the false pretense that you want a friendship when you know you want to be with this person. You gotta be genuine about it. And if you genuine, maybe a relationship might happen. Like, you gotta come out, man. I like you. You ain't feeling me right now, but I'm gonna let you know that I like you. It's not no, oh, I just want to be your friend. Fuck that. I like you and I want you. And I'm going to keep pursuing you until you shoot me down. Keep shooting me down, but I'm going to keep trying. Don't be no nigga that, or maybe they go female too. Don't be no person that, I want to be your friend, knowing damn well you're going to be with this person. Don't be that person. Because that person, like, you got ill. I feel people like they got ill intentions. They pretty much what they doing, because they trying to got, like I say, friend their way into your life. They trying to, like, y'all know, like they trying to plant themselves in your life on a false precinct that they're your friend. We know damn well they trying to be with you. But other than that, we're gonna go to the next.
In other words, that Trav will say, you doing all this shit for her, and she ain't even gonna let you smell it.
You ain't gonna smell it.
Yeah.
You was not gonna smell it, taste it.
See, but similar to them letters, no one could do it better. I check cheddar like a food inspector. My homie Strick told me, dude, finish your breakfast. So that's what I'ma do, take you back to the dude with the Lexus. Fast forward the jewels and the necklace. Let me tell you dudes what I do to protect this. Shoot at you actors like movie directors.
It's the Nasty Hour with Gen Talk Podcast. We're here. The next topic is, do men really want freaks? Or are they capping?
Cap.
Oh, hell. Major cap.
They don't know what they want, in my opinion.
I mean, it's
levels to the shit.
Hey, it is levels to it. Sometimes you just want somebody nasty, and sometimes you want somebody wholesome.
You know how many times I had to fake being shy just to allude to a male's ego? I don't like that.
I'll be telling him myself. I just be talking to him. I'll be like, look, this is a safe haven. I don't judge you. I'm not a judgmental person because I'm not perfect. If you want to do something.
I don't need a speech. I just need to do my thing. You do your thing. I do my thing. We do our thing.
You know what I'm saying? Just make them feel comfortable. And once they open up, then, hey,
That's the most important thing, make them feel comfortable. Like, once you make a female feel comfortable.
You're in there, buddy.
Yeah, you're basically in there. But at the same time, if she ain't go for it, just leave it alone. If you keep on pursuing it and she keeps on saying no, you look like an asshole. Just move on to the next.
You know what it is, though? Men don't understand non-verbal actions. It's like, yeah. Y'all really don't. God. It's like, we be trying to be nice. We be trying to be like nice, but y'all don't be understanding. Like, seriously, if a female is giving you head and you grab the back of her head and start wham, 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 like slamming her head on your dick, and she politely takes your hand and be like, hey, that's not necessary.
Yes, it is.
Y'all don't get that. It's like,
what you like, doing it for?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But yeah, why am I doing
why are we doing
to please you? Shit. Yeah. Let me do my thing.
Let me do my thing. Females, though. You do your, like you just said, you do your thing, I do my thing.
Because yeah, women can double, just, look, look women can do anything to us. They can do anything.
No, we cannot.
Shit, if a nigga hitting that shit right,
man, y'all start please.
Shit. He's slapping us and all that shit, scratching our back. Like, damn, please don't scratch my back. How that sound? Please don't scratch my back. That hurts.
Whatever. I bet cheating buddy, if a female try to play with one of y'all booty holes, I bet your ass kick her ass.
See, now,
hell yeah.
That's
hell yeah. Oh, that's like, bro, come on.
Oh. Oh, oh my god.
Hey, you can get the gooch.
Get that gooch.
You get the gooch.
Shit. Yeah, wrong with the gooch.
But you know what, though? I honestly, like Shell said, y'all don't know what the fuck y'all want.
Yeah,
because let me ask y'all, have any of you gentlemen ever been just intimidated because the mm-hmm. first sexual encounter you had with a female, she was a lot more, I guess, experienced than you expected?
Yes.
No.
She fucked the shit out of me.
That don't happen to her.
There you go. What you say, Mike?
She fucked the shit out of me.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Oh, my God.
Gotta be prepared.
I wasn't prepared.
And then the thing about it is, y'all has these such high expectations of us, and here we are. Y'all done got us comfortable. Y'all done took us out of dinner. Y'all done mm-hmm. showed us a good time, and we done mm-hmm. had these drinks, and mm-hmm. now everybody at home feeling themselves, and things yep. lead one way to the, you know, like, hey, you know what? He showed me a good time. Let me show him one. Uh-huh. Then y'all hear from his ass the next day.
Do your thing,
yeah, but yeah, like that's the thing, like that's a man, that's, yeah, it's an ego thing in the bedroom, so you don't want to be out there, like, damn, she don't put this thing on me, like, you know, when you can't, you know, you just lay down and your dick be stuck to your lid, like, God, yeah, I remember thinking, like, you can't even move, he's like, but she done did some shit to me, he's like, you can't even move, like, God, damn, what about her?
Got a wet ass.
Got a wet ass. Dick stuck to your leg.
And you sitting on top of the wet stain. And it's hot.
Man, shit.
Seriously, though, like, for real, it's funny because me and my girls have actually had this type of conversation. Like, seriously, we was like, girl, like, as soon as we get, you know, into the bedroom and you really show them, like, what type of freak you is, then it's, you know, he treats you like you're a regular ass bitch. Why I just can't be a good woman with some good pussy? That's all I'm trying to understand. What is the big fucking deal?
About what?
Like, why I just can't be... quote-unquote, the total package. Like, I could definitely be an independent, strong black woman that can handle hers in the bedroom.
Well, if you give it to him raw, you're already fucking up.
Huh?
Hmm?
You said if you fucking raw, you already fucking up.
Oh man, come on, man. 2021.
You know this.
Hey. Emotion make you cry sometimes. And Ross ain't be emotional.
But I told Michael Chad, I said, you put me good like that, you be sitting there smoking a cigarette saying, this bitch ain't never gonna leave me.
Man, like for real. Like I be wondering sometimes, I'm like, you know, was I too much? Sometimes I be wondering if I was too much. And me, like I said, I got boundaries. You know, I ain't into anal, I ain't into threesomes, I ain't in none of that. But nonetheless, I'm going to make sure you got full access to what's going on here.
And you said you ain't in the anal. Hold on. You ain't in the anal, but you said you died for the push, though.
No, I don't like the push.
What do you want?
Nah, I ain't really into it. Like, you ain't got to fool with that back there. Like, for real? Nah, I have had, you know, somebody, a couple, you know, put their mouths back there. But who am I to stop them?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But it's like, I don't know. Sometimes I feel like, you know, you create this strong bond with a person over months. And then, you know, okay, it's like, okay, let's take it to another level. Then you take it to that other level. And then, you know, I feel like sex, you should be able to freely express yourself. If you're having sex, why hold back? Like, are you trying to show this person what their future could be like, or are you just trying to bullshit this person? But what I'm starting to learn is maybe as females, we have to stroke the male ego in the bedroom as well, because when you sit up there, you spin around with it still inside, you blowing minds, and this motherfucker, this bitch for real. Like, I can't fuck with this bitch for real, for real. Like, I be wondering, they be thinking like, man, I can't fuck with her for real. She gonna ruin me.
Some niggas just don't want the ego shows. They want to earn that shit.
That's why you ask, what do you answer at first?
Three or four months of talking and dating and kissing, I think you know, I mean, I'm not putting a time limit on me, but I'm just saying if you put in time to actually build a vibe, get to know this person, and then it's time to go to the next level, like, why does the sex have to change things? It's like, you already know you want this person physically. You get this person physically, and this person is giving you what they feel like you deserve. And then things just get awkward after the fact. It's like, I think sometimes you men say you want these freaks or whatnot, but then when you actually get these freaks, you're like, oh, wait a minute. Maybe that ain't what I was bargaining for.
No man ain't gonna turn down no freak, especially like she's a freak. Like, come on.
You can never get too much good pussy. Shit.
I know, especially with him. Like what Ply said, especially snatching that new little grip thing. And make you grab back like, oh, Lord. No, make your knee go in limp. Like, go in that little limp.
Just a minute.
Your knee buck a little bit.
I don't think pussy can keep a man, like, at all.
It can't, but still, it's good.
It's not going to be able to keep a man, though, like, for real.
No, that's not.
Hey, I told you, man, the girl didn't need that time.
But like I told you, like I said, I'm like, with this little situation, it's like, okay, so what if we do end up, you know, hanging out or whatever, and one thing leads to another.
He greased the cheeks.
I am doing cartwheels and
shit. Cartwheels? Jesus.
Oh, fuck. Cartwheels.
Not with them knees.
What a slap. You know, it's like, damn, like, do you do this with everybody? I be wondering, they be thinking, do you do this with everybody? Like,
No. See, that's the difference between
real niggas,
a confidence man and a man that had confidence in somebody insecure. True. I wonder now who you doing it to. No, you didn't do it and do it again. Like, hey, man,
it's my time. Shit.
I promise you, it's my time at the door. Hell, I don't
pay. Yeah, try to do it again.
That picture coming from that bullpen, coming to pitch, goddamn. It's my time, goddamn.
Yeah,
I hit that shit.
Make it make sense, man. Like, I'm serious. Like, this has actually been a full in-depth conversation between me and my friends. And, you know, one of my homegirls was like, yo, I really do think I might just be doing the most when I be fucking these niggas, like, for real. And it throws them off because, you know, they see me, they think I'm this good girl, which I am a good girl, but I enjoy having sex. And when I have sex, you know, I want to give it my all. I want to do, you know, I want to try different positions and this, that, and the third. And she was like, I think I just might be a little much. And I was like, bitch, I agree. Maybe I do a little too much. Maybe I'm an overachiever in this aspect, like, for real. But I don't know. Because, I mean, nonetheless, you know, the vibe doesn't stay the same. But, of course, you get those random, hey, what you doing? How you doing? Are you on my mind? I miss you. Hey, queen. That's my favorite one. Hey, queen.
This nigga is Drew stupid.
Hey.
Drew stupid.
It's like, man, I don't think men, like, we said, do we really want a freak? Me personally, I want a freak. I got him. I'm taking him.
Hey, bro.
God damn. Man, she is a freak. I think she is a freak. You know what I'm saying? No, I'm fucking. I'm leaving it up. Well, yeah.
So my question is, when you say a freak, what kind of freak? Because, I mean, she could be a freak in the sheets, but...
Yeah. She a freak in the sheets. And whatever, how the other part goes, she a lady in the streets and a freak in the sheets. Like, that's how it goes. Like, shit. Like, I don't do the mouth spin.
My ultimate goal.
Oh, yo, hold up, y'all. Hold up, y'all.
When I'm having sex with someone.
Hold up. Oh, well.
My ultimate goal is for them to come. That is my ultimate goal. By any means necessary, I'm gonna reach my goal. If I have to do a cartwheel, if I have to spin around, if I have to bust into a split, even if I gotta break through a Charlie horse, by any necessary, if we're naked, my, because honestly, I'm automatically think his goal is the same thing, make me come. So my goal is, hey, who's coming first? You know what I'm saying? Like, for real. So I'm like, I'm gonna pull out some moves, you know, like I said, I ain't, you know, I consider myself a freak, but I ain't into like if you ain't into the next level, the question, females get asked this question often, do you like girls? No, I don't. Don't add one to the room. Don't do none of that shit. I'm not with all of that. I'm not with anal or nothing like that. But anything that's penetrating penis, I'm going to try to do it. I'm going to try to perfect it. I'm going to do my damn thing. I'm going to feel like a failure if you don't come.
Sure, you said, do men want freaks or something?
In the sheets or like a freak?
No, because my thing, I guess I'm just not really looking at it as in the bedroom in general. I'm just looking at it at all aspects. Because if you look at somebody like Cardi B, she presents herself as being a freak or freaky or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And so I know a lot of men, they judge her and say, well, they wouldn't want their woman like her. You know, they would want, you know, more of a wholesome woman or whatnot. But then you turn around and you entertain these type of women. You entertain the Cardi B's or the ones that, you know, be on Facebook, you know, taking pictures, you know, with their ass showing, you know what I'm saying, from behind showing their ass, that type of stuff. That's that aspect that I guess I was looking at. I really wasn't all the way looking at what how Keisha was saying. I was just looking at it in different ways as well. So that's why I had asked Trey when he said, you know, about his girlfriend. I was like, when you say you, I mean, I'm sorry, Trap. No, I didn't mean to say that.
Nah, you good.
But, I was wondering when you said what you said, you know, when you say you like the freak, okay, do you like just the freak in the sheets or you just overall, like, you know,
yes, freak, like I'm saying, not overall freak, but I won't be a freak, like,
because I was like, gonna say now,
she's like, you know what I'm saying, she turn around and do something
on Facebook that you don't like, then how you gonna say you like a freak?
Now, that's an open hold up. I want her to be like, look,
men want, I be wondering, do y'all really want closet freaks?
Yeah. I'm talking about that, I like being a freak, like, and like being sexual with a person. It just don't start in the bedroom room. We start with the sex. No, this shit got, ain't that like some build up sex? Like, you got build, like, you build that shit up. Hey, she might send you a sex video, but start sexing or some shit. Then that shit lead up to some goddamn, y'all should see how I'm looking at this.
Man, bro, that should be random as fuck. I'm like, oh my.
Oh, yeah, God. That's random.
That's to me, honestly speaking, like stuff like that, that's relationship type stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I'm
not finna send no video of me with just somebody I did be kicking it with from time to time. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real. I'm in early 30s. I ain't no dummy. Like, for real. I ain't finna just be sending out no damn videos just to make this nigga day. But if we're in a relationship, then yeah, I might, you know, hey, daddy waiting on you to come home type shit. But what I'm just saying is, like, in reference to when you do finally actually have sex with this person, does her performance change the way you look at her?
Hell no.
My main objective is like what you said. I'm trying to make you come so I can get that phone call back. Say, damn, that was some good ass shit. I want that phone call back. That's my whole goal, is to make you come. What about it?
Take your time, baby.
Take your time.
Yeah, I feel like every dude want a girl that's, you know, freaking the bedroom though. You know what I'm saying?
I don't be knowing shit because sometimes I be wondering. Maybe I'm a little overwhelming. Maybe.
Why do you feel like that? Like, what do they do for you to feel that way? Like, why are you questioning yourself?
The thing about it is this, because this is what happened. You meet somebody and they will whine and dine you up until that time does come. And then you go in and then it goes straight from whining and dining to the phone calls are later and later and later in the day to the point where it's just really and truly ain't shit open and you hitting me up. You know what I'm saying? It's like, goddamn, bro. Like, we were just going out to eat a few weeks ago. What the fuck changed?
So you're saying that now, you know, that you had sex, all the wine and dining, going out to eat and stuff, all that stopped?
It just stops. Okay, so I can look at it from two ways. I can look at it from two ways. He got what he wanted or whatnot, but does the fact that, okay, we built this vibe and then, you know, we do end up having sex, does the vibe get depreciated based off my performance?
I see what you mean.
I get what
you see what I'm saying. It's like, yeah, okay, you think you're with this late, oh yeah, man, hey man, I talked to this girl, she take her kids, she got her own car, all in place, own money, this, that, and third. Then we get in the bedroom and you slick think I'm a whole hoe out here. And then it's like, damn, man, I knew it was too good to be true, but shit good, though. Like, you know what I'm saying?
That's the whole point of going out and hanging out. He's supposed to get to know you. So before y'all even have sex, you should already know what type of female you is.
But that's what I'm saying, though. The way he treats, the way I'm treated after the fact changes after we have sex. And the thing is, it goes from wanting to actually impress me to just only wanting to fuck me.
Yeah, I see what I'm saying.
You put too much pressure on me. I would think that would actually make him want to do more. You know, I would think that
Stop bringing out the tricks out the bag the first time.
I be pulling
right. You gotta give
a little taste. I be cutting jokes in half.
You know something? Oh, I'm gonna do some better shit. Bring next time. Bring put add a little more to the Hey, Lamo, bring Lamo out there. Oh, damn.
Trisha trying to make them make tacos.
Next time, bring a little bit more. You get too much at one time. You got to get that shit in moderation. You got to spoon feed. You got to get in the whole pot.
He basically saying,
you know, what's so unfortunate about it is, like, I feel like, you know, and that actually crossed my mind, but I'm like, damn, you know, because I enjoy having sex. I do.
Hey, don't get
like, if I enjoy, like, if I'm doing something I enjoy, of course, you know, it's like riding a bike. You get to it. And it's like, damn, I literally have to salvage the vibe by limiting myself in something I enjoy. And that crossed my mind recently. Like, should I just lay there the first night?
Yeah.
And then on the second night, hop on top. And then next time, suck some dick. Then the next time, you know, like,
yeah, I love that time, bro. I know you girl told me that one time.
I gotta do is give him a little sample.
Yeah, I know what I'm saying. She can't be you can't be Keisha the first time.
Okay, I can see if dude was a virgin. 9 out of 10, he ain't a virgin. So I'm sure he had plenty of other women that then did the same thing.
Nah, baby, he had no speech.
I mean, not saying like that. I'm just saying, I'm pretty sure he had freaking women. So why would, I don't see why would that would change, you know, just like
it's almost, you know what I think it's like? It's like that moment you find out Santa Claus ain't real. It's like, oh, wow. Like, for real.
And the thing is, make him make tacos.
Burnt biscuit in the morning.
No, I don't even be cooking. I don't cook for niggas like that, for real.
I don't know.
Like, dead ass. I cut back on it, actually. And yeah, so, like, I cut back on, like, you know, coming to my house and we chilling, Netflix chilling, like, for real. Like, I cut back on a lot of that, for real. But I think that's what it's like. It's like finding out Santa Claus ain't real. It's like, damn, this wholesome girl, cool as fuck. You know, I vibe with her, this, that, and third. And then it's almost like my performance in the bedroom kind of clouds their judgment. Like, damn, like, is she doing this for every nigga she talked to? I know I ain't the only nigga she talking to. She a good person, you know what I'm saying? I be wondering what be changing the dynamic, because the thing is, it's not like they cut me off. It's not a matter of being cut off, but the things that they do to actually, you know, get, and yeah, it could be, yeah, you just did what you did just so you could get the sex. But it's like, so you just gonna throw respect out the door? You know what I'm saying? Does that make sense?
Yeah, I feel what you're saying.
It's like, you know what I'm saying? You respect me so much as a female, so you're capable of respecting me up until you get what you want. Okay, now you got what you want, and it's just like, okay, now it's only, I'm only hit her up after a certain hour. Like, yo, here's the thing with me, like, for real. If we having sex, it was strategically planned. I made sure there weren't no kids in the house, or I made sure I went to your house. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like, no, we do this all the time type shit. You know what I'm saying? So I put in effort. There's candles and oil, and I thought about this. Like, I knew I wanted to have sex with you tonight. And so therefore, I'm going to make it special. But shit, after you,
they're just like, you know, they say some people hire a rich person and get rich, come at broke, because, like, you know, once they get rich, or might say they get $1 million, they work ethic change. So they stop doing stuff they did to get $1 million. So once they get that $1 million, this shit starts slack off. It's there not a work they don't work for. They go, hey, I ain't gonna do that no more.
I'm on hiatus for dating right now for a good little minute. So when I do decide to date again, I'm gonna consider, you know, hey, just laying. I'm just gonna be a lazy bitch the first night.
Keesh. You ever consider dating a white dude?
I have. I've dated white guys before in the past, and their performances in the bed is the reason why I won't date them now.
Well, on to the
tune in next time.
Like the day you ever see an actual white penis, it just ruins you. Like,
oh man.
He shy.
By golly, this some good ass pie.
Golly.
I tell you what.
It's like, oh, it's like not even the same complexion as their body. Yeah. It's like, ugh. Man.
That man's had a foot Keisha in a polo.
It only took one. It took one to ruin it for a whole race. It took one person, and he's engaged now. I'm happy for him. Like, for real, I'm like, girl. Ugh.
What an episode, boy! What an episode.
Moccasins, wallabies, and Birkenstocks. Keisha, you want to come to all the party with
I'm
the boys?
I'm not saying all white men are gross. It's just like you know, just like, it's like your first time having a different food and you just don't like it and you'll never eat it again. Like, ugh.
What the hell, bro?
She will not make it out though. And that's all you gonna see.
Let me see. Oh shit.
Like, bro, you know, if I see a handsome white man, well, he's fine. But he tried to talk to me, I'm like, I wouldn't dare, like, for real. Like, I mean, I love black men anyway, though, for real, though. That's just a me thing. Like, you know, but I'm not prejudiced to other races, you know, but you know, I dip and daddle, but if I dip and I daddle, I'm not done.
You ever been dipped?
I made a little mint chocolate.
You know, like for real. I used to be sitting back, I'm like, I mean, I'm pretty sure there's some white man out there well endowed. I'll probably never find out though.
We don't know what the future holds.
Who knows? Like, I might end up with an Asian. Y'all all be looking at me like, really, Keisha?
Yeah, yeah. I'm like, hey, we're gonna come up.
Man, stupid.
Okay, good. Nobody make, never mind.
Hey, go ahead, take out another photo. I forgot what happened.
I was in a serious like situation with a white man. He was actually a police officer. He was actually a police officer down there where I went to college at. Like, for real, he used to look out for me. He'd take good care, real sweet guy. But it was like, one time.
Go ahead,
nine.
I
ain't gonna call him out.
No.
Last time I reached out to him for some legal advice, his wife answered the phone.
Oh, yeah. Did he marry a black woman?
Nah, white. A Karen.
Well,
no dead ass. His wife named no cap. His wife named was Karen.
We gonna have to take the part out because he gonna know who you talking about.
No, we're not even friends on social media. Like, this was years and years.
Well, this is awkward.
Years ago.
Know what I'm saying? Right?
What you say? His name is Drew Kilt.
I'm still not gonna call his name.
I know we ain't gonna call that.
You know why I won't call his name out? Because my friends know exactly who I'm talking about. So it's like, you know, if I went to college. If anybody went to college with me and they knew me, they knew about the white officer that I was dating because he looked out for all of us. He did. I used to throw big parties in college or whatever, and I used to hit him up like, yo, I'm throwing a big party here. You know, if you get a call about it, you know, let your people know. Like, for real, none of my parties ever got shut down because the police knew, like, okay, yo, that's his girl. It's straight. And if it got too wild, you know, he'll call me like, hey, y'all need to chill out. But it never even was that bad, though, because he would tell me, he was like, yo, they on the radio. But, you know, I had party etiquette. So
I stayed in like these townhouses and there was like three of them. And I would go to each neighbor and let them know, hey, I'm throwing a party. You're invited. But I'm just letting you know there's going to be a party here. It's going to be a lot of people. Everybody was pretty much cool about it. So there weren't no real complaints. So, yeah. I was strategic with that or whatnot, but still, if there was a snitch among the crew, I let him know, like, hey, I'm having this party. X, Y, and Z, And he knew what was up, and he knew we weren't disturbing the peace. He knew we weren't tearing up shit. He was a cool ass dude, real, real cool. I have nothing bad to say about him other than, ugh, but that's it.
Did he have rhythm?
Was it like a pencil?
What the hell are you talking about?
You ever seen a plum?
All right.
I
meant rhythm as in dancing.
He was just... You know what? This is what attracted me to him. He was a white guy that acted like himself. You know what I'm saying? You know how you meet some white people, they like try to be hood and all that. I love white people that just act like white people, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? You ain't trying to change the way you talk or walk or dress to appropriate my culture. You're being yourself and you just so happen to be cool as fuck, you know? That's what that was. And that's what attracted me to him. It was, I just got a text message. What are you doing?
Uh-oh. Yeah.
Tell him you start dating.
Huh?
No.
You ain't gonna say, huh?
Wow, man. You gotta be on Keith's ass.
Huh? She gonna say that first home.
You know what? My friend said it best. I need adult supervision.
Yeah, that's why I said, you got to be on your ass. Yeah, you already don't forget. No, we back.
Trans, you got to stay on the teacher. You stop dating. You right, bro. You right.
Oh, man. We got that. I know we got about 2 hours or so.
Well, we only using the second half, so we good.
All right.
No, my second answer might be how long this is. It might be an hour. It might be an hour and 20. Mm. Yeah, man.
Yeah. But yeah, so yeah, that was my question, like, to the fellas. Like, if you get a girl, you date her, and you have what it is let me, I guess real so really the question is, you created this
freak,
this expectation of this girl. And then in the bedroom, you see another side of her. Does that change the way you look at her?
My opinion, no, it don't.
No, it don't. It really don't.
Freaks come out at night. What?
What?
It really don't. It really don't.
What was the question?
Because, she basically saying you don't create the expectation of this girl of being this freak. And then you get it, and she show you she about that life. She really left for you.
She doing some cool shit.
If you meet a girl and you're thinking she's Michelle Obama, but she shows you Megan Thee Stallion in the bedroom, does that make you look at her any different?
Actually, it turns me on.
Yeah, turn me on even more.
And she ain't going nowhere.
Uh-oh. Splash,
well,
bro.
Well, where yours at? Well, Drew, you with yours?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Trav, I know Trav with his. Mike, why you ain't settled down?
The pimp in
what was your question, Shay?
Might say he asked that a lot.
No, Mike said the pimp in him has what? The pimp in you dad?
I'm out here thugging and chilling, man, trying to get this money, man. I ain't doing shit. What was your question, Shell?
I didn't have a question. Don't bring me in.
Try it.
Yeah, I'm chilling, man. I ain't got nobody on my line.
Nobody.
You're wondering, like, you know, but because this actually was an actual conversation that we had for drinks one day. And she, you know, she was like, I just think, you know, when I show the freak that I am in the bedroom, it changes the way that they look at me. And I was like, girl, you might be on something. Maybe.
You should have got your own girl. You should have got her. Come on.
Yeah, I should have. I didn't think about it, but it was just, you know, it's just, you know, you had these conversations amongst friends, and you know, it made me think that's a good something to talk about. Cause I always wonder.
That's a good
if, you know, a girl's performing for real. Cause you know, then you see on, you know, social media, you don't want no shy girl. She don't suck dick. She immature. Take her childish ass home and blah, blah, blah.
Stand in the corner.
Then yesterday, you deep throw the motherfucker. Now he looking at you all. Bro.
Like Eddie Murphy.
Unhand me.
Hold on.
You really ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, you ain't going nowhere. Mm-hmm. Wait, shit
is sexy though.
You mine. I ain't be like, oh, what a move. I ain't gonna get you. Nah, what a, don't be a menace to South Central. Motherfucker, you ain't going nowhere. I'm watching this tonight.
Motherfucker, scream.
But you know what, though? That's crossed my mind, too, because it's like, you don't want to keep the vibe going. You don't want to actually, like, date or whatever, but you still want to make yourself relevant in my life. You know, like, dead ass, like, I stopped talking to this one cat for a good minute. And he hit me up. I mean, and I kid you not, the entire time we was like talking, I couldn't get this guy to be sentimental for shit. You miss me? Hey, man, chill out. Okay, well, whatever. Okay, I'm not gonna press it. Then we stopped talking. Hey, man, I miss you. You miss me? Hey, you man, miss me, baby? I had a dream about you.
Lots of good time.
Hey man, you know what I'm saying? It's like, bruh, like, I don't know. Honestly, y'all men are weird.
Hey, we just like a chase sometimes, that's all.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. Y'all be chasing for no reason.
No, we want y'all to chase us sometimes.
Y'all instead of that, y'all are build a vibe. You'll feel a certain type of way about this person, and then I think what it is the root of it all is what causes the change? Is it the sex? Is it the performance of the sex? Is it the fact that you was even able to have sex? Did you even think you had a chance in having sex with this particular person? And now that you have gotten it, it's like, have y'all ever seen that on that Facebook post that said, imagine getting done having sex with somebody and they crush your name out?
Crush out.
No, like, really?
Seriously, like, is that what's going on? Like, what is really going on?
Because, you know, people do that, you know, maybe, you know, early 20s, whatever, but in your 30s, you shouldn't be. I mean, that's immature as hell to have a list crossing out.
You know what? No, I'm gonna do it on purpose just to see what happens.
No,
I'm
not
gonna pull
that.
out a notebook.
You know what?
Said, this girl got a whole binder. The audacity.
I see. Don't do that.
Don't do that. Please don't.
No, don't do that. For real.
I just wonder, like, for real.
I don't know. Some men think different, like move different, like so. It all
you do. Don't give it to them too early.
I told you.
True enough. Yeah. Giving it to them too early, that makes plenty of sense. Yeah. You know, like, damn. But it's like after actual vibe has been, but that's what I'm actually basing it on, the fact that we've had built a connection. We're talking on a regular, we go on dates on a regular, like, and then, you know, the time comes. Like, yeah, I said I'm not dating, but, you know, there's this cat that I do, you know, we go out pretty frequently. We try to go out once a week if we can, and we haven't gone there yet. And we've been talking for about a year.
Oh, Oh man, what's going on? A year and no sex? What's going on?
Honestly, schedules. Like, you know what he does. He has a very demanding job, and y'all know me. I'm always working. And then now that I'm not like actually employed and working for myself, I'm super busy. It's slammed. So it's been super hard for us to actually like catch up with one another. But when we do, we try to make the best of the time, but we've never been intimate with one. As a matter of fact, we've been talking for over a year, and we just actually had our first kiss recently. Like,
that's who you gonna marry?
No, this is the same when I told y'all, I was like, bro, he don't smoke weed. I'm loud, he's quiet, I'm outgoing, he's reserved. You know what I'm saying?
That's like, me, that's me, that's me.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know, because it's like, I don't know if our lifestyles, I think what it is I honestly feel like there's going to be times where I may quote unquote embarrass him. And I don't want to feel that way when I'm with somebody. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm fun and I'm outgoing. And if we're in a room full of your friends, and y'all are all reserved and her. And I'm like, I need to loosen up, shit. I need to have some strippers up in this bitch. Like, man, you know, like.
I'm laid back and super and shit like that. But shit, like, I just can vibe with people. Like. That don't mean,
Some people can vibe with people, but honestly, I'm very hesitant about bringing him around people because I feel like he's just going to just sit back and just be quiet. And, you know, we're going to have to put a fucking bell around his neck. Like, he
let him hang.
Yeah.
If he's nonchalant and he likes you, he's going to vibe with you.
It's just, and you know, I even had a conversation with Mike. It's like, yo, like, he's sitting there, you know, he tried to hit me with the whole I'm not ready for a relationship type thing. I'm like, bro, I was not looking for one with you. Like, I do not see a future with you, because it's like, me, I want somebody that more so compliments me. I don't understand opposites attract or whatever, but I know me as a person. I'm a fun person. I'm the person that hosts the stuff at their house. I'm the person you're going to have to be comfortable about being around other people. And, you know, me and my friends, you know, y'all have been around me and my friends. Y'all see how we roll. It ain't nothing too crazy. Y'all actually mesh in just fine. You know what I'm saying? It's not like y'all are awkward or uncomfortable, because y'all mesh in just fine. Even Drew, and Drew don't really say much when he's around my friends and whatnot, but it's not like Drew is awkward. You know what I'm saying? Drew is a team player. You can tell Drew is not uncomfortable when he's around my friends or whatnot. So it's like, you know, I kind of want that when, you know, even if you're still awkward, don't be all
uptight.
Don't be that silent, judgy type. And I get that from him, if that makes sense.
Well, you don't need to hang
around
up then,
because
you know we
can tell
them.
Hello, exactly. Man, we but see, that's why me and old buddy, the one from the GZ and Gucci night, that's why, you know, he was cool. You know, he interacted with everybody. You know what I'm saying? Me and him, we complimented each other. He just gives me a fucking headache, but that's neither here nor there. But nonetheless, you know, that's why me and him still like, I'm not as strongly tied to him, but he's still, you know, a special person to me, because it's like we have that connection, so to speak. But yeah, I don't think that's the person I'm gonna marry, for real. Not him. Mm-mm. And I already know, and I'm more worried, like, if we do go to that next level, like, I have no idea what the fuck I'm gonna expect out of that.
Oh, so he laid back on camera, come out there, pull that Mr. Marcus on.
Hello.
And goddamn Whistler Pipes. You know what I'm saying? Don't go out there with the Tims on. Butt ass nigga with some Tims and some tube socks on. Go.
And then here I am wearing Tims too. I'm like, what's up, nigga?
I got Tim's soup.
What you got to do? What's up, B? We gonna chicken noodle soup or what, nigga? Like, for real. What's up?
She gonna say that dick was bomb, my guy.
Dead ass.
Oh man.
Popping, son. What's popping?
Oh, you really ain't gonna hear from him.
Damn near.
Yeah, man. We're gonna end it out, Mike.
I think me and Shell got the answers we were looking for tonight. I appreciate y'all.
Hey, anytime. That's all. That's our motto. We turn conversation to dope ass content.
So now I'm gonna just ease on in, you know, first night and just lay.
Let him take control the first night, and then. Next time, shit.
Yeah, I grab you by the neck. Come here, like I be on some damn scorpion shit.
Oh man,
get over here.
You're not, y'all.
This has been the Gentile Podcast. Thank y'all for listening to us today. This is late night hour, so put your kid to bed. I'll listen to part, but yeah, what you got to say, Michael?
Right. Oh,
my bad.
Oh, I thought you ended it off.
I'm not going to end it off. I know it's like, I read it, so.
Oh, okay. You just cut it part out. All right. It's been the Gen Top Podcast. And as always, we in the jungle, baby.
You said the monkeys asleep. ZZs. ZZs.
Yes, sir.
Good night.
There you go.
Roar.
You're listening to Jan Talk. Go. We in the jungle, baby. Mamba.